This episode of How to Spin Yarn has been brought to you by SpinOlution, state-of-the-art spinning wheels proudly made by families in the USA. And by My Local Wool. Find farms, festivals, artisans, and shops near you by visiting mylocalwool.com.
Welcome back to How to Spin Yarn, and this tutorial is called LASHED. Here are the fibers that we're going to be using for this tutorial. I'm going to try some raw cormo, a bit of a rolag, some flax top, some silk top, some black alpaca top, alpaca nylon roving, some domestic wool roving, some silk blend roving, alpaca wool roving. And what you'll need for this is a pair of scissors, because we are going to be breaking a lot of rules today. To prepare your fiber for this technique, you will need to cut it in 3-inch long, 2 to 3 inch long sections like this. And so once you've cut all the fiber you want to spin, then we will start spinning. Okay, now all of our fiber is prepped. I'm going to actually put some of this aside so that it's not all on my lap because I want to be spinning one section at a time. And so what we're going to do is we're just going to be spinning from the center on our wheel. So I'm going to set all this aside and then we'll go through it and make a yarn out of it. So we'll just start with a little bit of white first. Pinch the center of the fiber and bring it through your leader thread. And you want low tension at first so that you have time for this to twist. And then draft backwards from the center. And draft in tiny, like 1-inch segments. And we're gonna end up making a yarn that has kind of this lashed texture, but my leader thread let go of it, so just a minute. I'll tuck it through the leader thread so that I have a more secure beginning. There we go. It might even make sense for you to spin just a couple yards of regular yarn before beginning this technique. That way, if you're knitting, you can cast on with regular yarn before the texture shows up. Okay, so I'm just spinning from the center. And all those cut edges are making kind of an eyelash fuzzy texture on the outside of my yarn. And you can do this with just one color, or you can kind of stripe it like I'm doing. My favorite fiber to use for this technique is silk. It requires a lot of twist. But it's effortless and really fun. Just make sure you have enough twist in it so that it doesn't fall apart, because the staple length is a little bit shorter than what most animals grow. And with all the cut ends, it probably is more likely to fall apart if there isn't enough twist in it. Isn't that pretty? Love, love, love. And it's very easy. I originally learned this technique from a spinner named Lizette Hopkins. She taught it to me at Yarnival in California several years ago. And she said that she had learned it from someone in her spinning guild. So I'm not sure who originally came up with this idea, but I learned it from Lizette. And she called it eyelash. So that's why I call it lashed, because it's similar. Eyelash, lashed. Try some of this medium alpaca, probably nylon blend. Maybe it's alpaca silk though. And this is roving rather than top, so it's not as processed, so it makes more of a lumpy bumpy, not as even a yarn as this is commercial top, so all the fibers are going in the same direction, and that's going to create or make it easier to create an evenly textured lashed yarn. Fuzzy bobbin. So cute. I'll show you a close-up at the very end. I'm just going to spin through the rest of this wool that we cut. I guess the key to this technique is just the cutting of the wool. Everything else after that is pretty simple. Just tiny, tiny drafts, like half an inch or 1 centimeter drafting. I'm also using, I'm kind of pinching with 4 fingers as it drafts. I'm holding the roving with my middle finger and thumb, and I'm drafting with my other middle finger and thumb, just using as few fingers as possible to prevent from sculpting the texture. But yeah, you can create this really quickly. And I have my tension up relatively high. I like a good firm uptake. So the tension is naturally pulling the yarn out of my hands as I'm spinning, as opposed to me kind of giving the yarn into the orifice. So if you also like strong tension, you can kind of find a good spot where it's nice and high and just spin. My bobbin is loud. Sorry about that. Not sure if my camera's picking up on the little noises and rattles my wheel is doing today. I just finished some videos for the company that makes these wheels, SpinOlution. And a couple of the videos have been how to take the wheels apart and put them back together. So I just need to make sure that I've tightened up every screw. Okay, let's do a row lag. So we cut this row lag and it's very short. It's probably an inch long staple. There's the top and then there's the bottom that's been cut. I believe that if we spin with the bottom facing upward, we're not going to get much lashed texture because the ends are going to twist around each other. So I'm going to try spinning with the smooth top upward, and that way hopefully all those ends will be facing outward. But this will probably be just a really subtle technique, almost like a fuzz rather than a lashed, because the fibers are so short and they have a curve to them from being turned into a rolag. Basically, the way that they're processed is they're drafted off a drum carter. Okay, now I want to try this cormo. Ooh, and then we'll do the flax. So the cormo fleece I cut in half. I'm just going to lay it on top of itself and have the ends sticking out on both sides. And we'll just spin from the middle and see what happens. This might require a bit more drafting because these locks are raw, so they're... they have lanolin sticking them together a bit, and they haven't been brushed out. So I'm not sure if we're going to get the same consistent. Looks like we're not going to get that consistent texture. It almost appears that we're really not getting much of anything. We basically just said, hey, let me try a smaller chunk because I'm not getting much of anything. Let's try a little bit at a time. That's better. There we go. Look at that. This is amazing. So just a little bit at a time, we can get that. Fuzzy texture. Look at that. I think that's beautiful. Getting a little bit too thin at the end there. Very, very fine. I would love to play with plying this technique, which I'll do in my plied series, but I'm curious to see what this would look like plied. Oh, flax. We need to do flax. I love flax. It is one of my favorite textures because it is just impressive. Look at that. How fun is that? Super. Super fun. Flax is great if you want to do a really fine yarn with big lashed impact. Make sure you have plenty of twist in this yarn. I think that's the key to keeping it from falling apart, is you've got to make sure it's very firm with twist. I think that's the end of our flax. I'll finish up the silk. I don't know which is my favorite, the flax or the silk. The silk almost reminds me of feathers. It feels like downy feathers in texture. Now we're doing some domestic wool top. Okay, I think I'm about out. I hope you enjoyed this fun lashed tutorial. And once I'm done with this top, I'll take the bobbin off so you can see. Feel free to spin a couple yards of just regular yarn at the end of this for binding off if you plan on knitting or crocheting with this yarn. And this is what we've got. It reminds me of a woolly bear caterpillar. So cute.
Visit thisyarn.com for free patterns and projects exclusively designed for art yarns by art yarn spinners. What will you make with this yarn? If you have benefited from the education you received from my site and videos, pay it forward by making a donation on my website. Every donation goes toward my children's education. Thank you.